guacamole, holy guacamole, I just got hit by a car. And you're the one who swept me off my feet, pushed me in the street, left me in a coma. Guacamole me, guacamole you, I just got busted for drugs. And you're the one who sold me to the Fed, leaving me for dead, played me for a fool. Making guacamole, mix it in the bowly, I just got mauled by a bear. And you're the one who covered me with honey, thought it was so funny, how could you be so cruel? Take it. Hepatitis C. And you were standing there with a syringe. How it makes me cringe, breaks my heart in two. Holy guacamole, lumpy, green, and roly. Baby, I wouldn't change a thing. 'Cause even though I'm down upon my luck, I don't give a fuck, long as I have you. She was my true love, now she's dead and gone. She made me feel whole, and when I failed, she'd hold my hand when nobody ever would. She understood. She came with me everywhere I'd go. I miss her so. She was my only true love. She
testing, testing, check, test, testing, testing, 1, 2, 3, testing, testing, 1, 2, 3, check, testing, 1, 2, 3, testing, 1, 2, 3, help, help, testing, guava, falafel, Hello, everybody, and welcome to Henry's Kitchen, where today we're going to be teaching you how to make Henry's guava snacks.
Okay.
Google D's Nuts just resubscribed for 4 months. Thanks, Google D's Nuts. Hyphia says, is Henry short for Henrietta? I get asked this a lot, and the answer is yes. I also want to thank Dagoggy for subscribing. Normally, I'm able to see them after the fact, but I can't right now. Munch Hotel just subscribed. Thanks, Munch Hotel. I'm remote at the moment. I don't want to tell anybody exactly where I am because Fitch and Hat just resubscribed. Thanks, Fitch and Hat.
Okay.
It's just John just resubscribed for 3 months. First thing I want to ask is, technically speaking, are you guys able to hear me okay? Thanks, Beelzebub. Do you hear me okay? Help. Testing. The mic sounds good. Okay. I don't have my apron on, which is making me feel a little bit uncomfortable. I have a different setup. Everything's sort of topsy-turvy, but I've always liked to say that if you don't get out of your comfort zone every now and then, you die. Retro Boyo Boy says, hello, Henlips. I noticed that your stream title says remote stream. I see that you're streaming, but I don't see the remote. Please clarify. No, by remote, I mean I'm doing it from a remote location that's not my ordinary kitchen. Kairosa says, I am worried that you're on the lam from the law. Are you okay? I am okay. I'm safe. Double-edged board. Kitchen flannel look good. Thank you. Thanks. I need all the positivity I can get here. Correction says, guess I won't be getting out of my comfort zone anytime soon. Okay. Well, everyone type force and says, who's looking for looking after roast beef? I have a neighbor who's going to be checking in on roast beef. The neighbor's very old, so I'm not sure that they're able to operate a smartphone to send video or pictures, but I trust that roast beef is being fed. He's being given water, and he has ample space for bathroom experiences. Thanks, Offensive Pink. No Meeks just subscribed. I'm going to have a difficult time here because I noticed that after the subscriptions come up, they disappear for good. And I can't get them to come back, and it has to do with this widget. Gerald Hackington. But it wouldn't be a Henry's Kitchen stream if there wasn't something technical that went wrong. And my technical advisor, Quanto, is currently on a European trip.
Okay.
Lindsay 6669 just subscribed. Thanks, Lindsay. Zodbane. Oh, Jukobi just subscribed. Thanks, Jukobi. Zodbane says, you said welcome to Henry's Kitchen, but whose kitchen is this really? Thanks, Lictor 777 just subscribed. But did they relocate you? Do you need help? No, I don't actually need any help. Thanks, Zodbane. Let's see. Quanto is here checking in from his European vacation for technical support. Ah, there it is. Quanto is an amazing person. Quanto just came in from a European vacation of sorts to check in and give me some technical advice at a time when I really needed it. I'm somewhere near the coast of Jamaica, and I was visiting family down here, and it's a long story, but I didn't want people to forget all about me, and so I wanted to keep streaming. But thanks, Quanto, for checking in. It made me feel at home. Doinks says, I am an agent for the NSA. Are you currently on the run from any three-letter agencies? Do you need me to scrub the folder we have on you? Yeah, no, I'm again, I'm safe, but I appreciate that, Doinks. That's very nice of you. Thanks also to Lictor777777 for subscribing. But, you know, I'm hoping today we can do some songs, and I also do have a recipe. I'll be honest with you, this is not a Henry's Kitchen official recipe. This is something I found online that I thought was reasonable that I could do in the kitchen that I have here. This is the kitchen that we've got to work with. And since I am somewhere near the coast of Jamaica, I thought maybe a fun thing to do would be to make a guava dish, because guava is a fruit that actually is very popular here in the tropics. And so, you know, I thought maybe I'd do something like that. So, you know, why don't we just go ahead and get started here with that? Let me see here. How can I do this? Oh, yeah. So, I don't know why it looks like it's nighttime, but we're going to do the best that we can here. These are basically our ingredients. Well, hold on. Before I do that, I'm going to read to you a little bit about what we're going to be making here today. This is, I'm reading this from the internet. It's mydominicankitchen.com. So it's not me. I'm borrowing this from My Dominican Kitchen. So when I read about it, it's going to come from the voice of a different person. A few months ago, I was invited by the Laughing Cow to its Love Your Local event here in New York City. The event focused on helping reinvent snacking by showing how to create simple, easy, and delicious snacking ideas such as these creamy cheese and guava bites using the Laughing Cow cheeses. At the event, I had the opportunity to learn a great deal about crafting delicious southern snacks, etc. It kind of goes on for a while. But Chef Simmons shared two tips that resonated with me, mostly because it describes exactly what my approach when creating yummy snacks. She said, when creating a snack pairing, remember to keep it simple, no more than three components. That's a big one. Also, I think it's important to have a crunch in a snack. That's going to be our crackers today. People love chips for their crunch as much as their flavor. Crunchy food is fun. So keep that in mind when we make what we're going to be doing here. I want to talk to you a little bit about guava. What was that? I missed something here. Da Guava just gifted 5 tier 1 subs. Thanks, Da Guava.
Okay.
And Beelzebub just gifted Sonaket a sub. That's really awesome. You guys are making me feel like this is going well already. So let's talk a little bit about guava. The question is, what is guava? And the answer I'm going to get from Google right now. I can't believe how hard it is to just find what's guava here. Okay. This is from Wikipedia.com. Guava is a common tropical fruit cultivated in many tropical and subtropical regions. The common guava, Pisidium guajava, lemon guava, apple guava is a small tree in the myrtle family, Microtaceae, native to Mexico, Central America, the Caribbean, and North South America. I think that's Northern South America. It's kind of a contradiction. The name guava is also given to some other species in the genus Pisidium, such as strawberry guava, Pisidium catalinatum, and to the pineapple guava, Phalloja celuina. Sorry, I don't know what any of these terms are. In 2019, 55 million tons of guavas were produced worldwide. Yeah, you know, every time you go to Wikipedia, it's got all kinds of extra information. But basically, the short answer is it's a fruit. Insane Axeman says, is guava related to guacamole? It could be. I mean, it's definitely from the southern tropical region, so it could be. Hunted Spam says, guava and marshmallows is a winning combo. Oh, that's interesting. Well, we definitely are going to be doing cheese, which is not like marshmallows, but it's a food that looks a little bit like it from a distance, I guess. Akama-san says, how do you stay so youthful looking? I'm guessing that's probably sarcasm, but if it's not, I just, you know, I don't really do much. Just maybe try to walk as much as possible. But anyway, let's go ahead and take a look at the job ahead of us. We've got a lot of work to do.
Okay.
Thanks, Uhei76, for resubscribing. All right. This is also going to be a little bit awkward because I'm going to have to go across the room and I'm going to have to talk. But I also have to read what our instructions are. Zeus just resubscribed. Thanks, Zeus. And Uhei76. Okay, so I'm going to this recipe here. It says, for the first step, you will, well, let's go over our ingredients. We need 10 to 12 crackers, 5 wedges of creamy Swiss cheese. I don't have Swiss cheese. I have a sharp cheddar cheese. And 10 to 12 slices of guava paste or half a cup of guava jelly. So let's start with our guava jelly. Let's see here. We want to cut it up into 10 to 12 slices. So this is our guava jelly, guys. You can only get this in the southern troposphere. But it's basically a jam made from fruit, similar to any other kind of jam. I wonder, I might try to, wonder if there's a way to zoom in a little bit here. I'm not exactly sure what's happening here, but we basically have a block of some sort. And it's covered with plastic. I'm also not sure about how the internet's gonna be here today. Boy, I've already made kind of a mess. So we wanna slice this up into 10 to 12 slices. Here, I'm gonna make some adjustments, hold on. Are you able to see that? Are you able to see that a little bit better? Hopefully. Help. Check. Okay. So let's start cutting this up. We want 10 to 12 pieces. What I'm going to do is I'm going to cut them into first a manageable piece. I'm going to need another plate already. I don't know why it's so dark here. There's a light here. Did that help anything? No, I guess not. I don't know why it would really, but okay. So I'm gonna cut it up into blocks. I'm sorry that everything's pretty rough here technically, but I am in sort of the middle of nowhere. Wow, it got dark. Okay, what the hell's going on here? What is this? Exactly sure what's happening here. That's like two. Sorry, guys, I didn't want to have all these technical issues. All right, I'm gonna fix this. Hold on. I think I know what's happening. When I put the camera up, it gets moved. Yeah, this is crazy. Oh, I know. There we go. I think we got it. Shane Yes says this has a very early 2000s feel. That doesn't sound like a compliment, although that was a decent time for me anyway. But okay, yeah, this is the wireless cam, Quanto, but I think it looks better now. It was just on some kind of auto lighting mode or something, so. All right. So we're getting there. We're gonna have six pieces of this. Six, we want, what do we want? 10 to 12. So I think we're gonna stop there. And how are we're gonna make, we need these to be in threes because we have four bricks. And if you make three times four, Alexa, what is three times four? Oh yeah, I don't have Alexa here, so it's going to be tough to get some of the math done, but that's okay. But anyway, step one is basically complete here. Our, those are our guava paste bricks. We wanted 10 to 12 of them. We have them. Now it's time to break out our crackers. Why they make these things so hard to open. Oh, this is good. Yeah, these are already open basically. So this is way too many. So we just want 10 to 12. I'm gonna use, I'll do three of each. There we go. Last thing we need to do is our cheese, which I have here. This is called Smoky Pride, or Smoky Park cheddar cheese. Let's see if they have a sharp knife here I can use. No. So. This thing doesn't want to come off. Ah, jeez. They really, really did it here. Okay. I think I got it started. Once you get it started, it's better. I don't know why this is supposed to be the easy part, just trying to get the cheese out. Wow, that's pretty good though. Smoky Park. There we go. So similarly, we're gonna have we're gonna do four bricks. And we're going to cut the bricks into threes. You don't want to use a very sharp knife for this because I'm basically just cutting right into my fingers. So this is going to make a nice, what the French call a charcuterie plate. There should be 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay. Now the last part that we're going to be doing here is we're going to be we're going to be assembling. So okay, I kind of made a mess out of this. I'm going to take all these other plates and put them elsewhere. And I'm just going to take one plate, and we'll call this the assembly plate. This has some kind of stain on it. There we go. All right. I'm going to put our crackers down first. If you're doing this at home, you don't have to use the same kind of crackers that I'm using, but it definitely helps. All right, let's lay down these the cheese here. And you could do it in any order. If you want to do the guava jam blocks first, you could do that. But I'm doing it with the cheese down first. Since we did the math correctly, there's exactly 12 of each of these items, which is nice. Now, the last part is we're going to put the guava jam probably on top of it's going to be difficult. So what you want to do is put the guava jam next to the cheese, like so.
Okay.
Well, that was a silent apostrophe resubscribe. Thank you, and thanks, Zeus. We're getting there. We're doing this. And there's, you know, the nice thing about making a dish like this is you're not worrying about the oven, because since I was doing it remotely, I didn't know if I was going to have a hard time with the oven or not, but as it turns out, we didn't need it anyway. So this is coming out pretty good, I'd say. Hopefully you can see it and hear me okay. That's the only thing I'm worried about. But yeah, these
okay.
Modified Tube Sock 54 just resubscribed, so thanks for doing that. All right, I'm gonna take these, give you one last look at them here. This is what you call a charcuterie plate, and today we're making guava snacks, care of my Dominican kitchen. Let's see here. Hide White 2 says, am I in a spaceship? Answers no. Falkan says, careful so you don't cut yourself on the sharp cheese. Yeah, that's a good point. Phoenix 133, did you change kitchen? Yeah, we're doing this remotely if you're just joining us. That's why everything's a little bit topsy-turvy. Double-edged board says, my cheese isn't backwards like that. How do I flip it? You could probably, maybe you could turn the camera around. Akamison, how do you stay so youthful looking? Oh yeah, Akamison, so I'll tell you how you do that.
Okay.
Thanks, Barry Saxy. You eat good food like this. This is guava charcuterie snack. I don't know which part to get first. The cheese or the guava? Mmm. Now I'm gonna do the cheese. Pretty good. It's very filling. Lex4Alive says, how much cheese is there? This is about a half a brick of cheese. Saguaro U says, are these snacks vegan free? Yes. These are vegan free, and I want to make sure that everybody understands. Vegan free means that they're not vegan. You've heard of gluten free. That means there's no gluten in it. Vegan free means this is not a vegan dish. There was a lot of confusion about my vegan free gluten pizza. It was not vegan and it had gluten in it. There were people on the comment section saying he put an egg in there or he put mozzarella cheese. That's not vegan. And I responded and said, yeah, that's what I mean. It's vegan free and it's got gluten in it. So anyway, let's see what other comments we have here. Stars and Skeletons, I don't have guava, but I have guano. Will that work? I think, I don't know what guano is, probably the same thing, I think. Daff 00 says, are you going to cook them? No, this is not a cooking dish and I wouldn't know how to operate. There's kind of a fancy looking oven here and I wouldn't really even know the first thing about trying to operate it. So what we're gonna do now is I've got a couple of song requests and I'm gonna do them for you. But I wanna say thank you so much to everybody who's joining us today. I love streaming and I love seeing you guys because it's really, it's my social world. And I didn't think I was gonna, that this was gonna be able to happen for me, but I did bring my computer just because I really wanted to. And I wanna thank you for working with me in terms of the weird technical setup.
Okay.
Joe Matha just resubscribed. Thanks, Joe Matha. But anyway, so thanks everybody. And let's grab the guitar here. See what kind of requests we have here.
Okay.
Goose Lifter just subscribed. Thanks, Goose Lifter.
Okay.
I guess we don't need that. That was Franz Schubert. Just resubscribed. Thanks, Franz Schubert. Let's see what some of these requests we have here. I didn't have a lot of time to learn them. We have one here. Thanks, Knifey McEdge just gifted Gallimoth Forever a subscription. Kaffee wanted to hear a song from Three Dog Night. Lozrick just subscribed. Thanks, Lozrick. I don't know if you guys can see the guitar very well here, but let's try to.
Okay.
Upside Down Ace just resubscribed. Do you guys hear the guitar okay? Zasalamel. V1 the cat, are you in Holiday Home? No, No, I don't have a holiday home. I'm actually visiting family where I am, but the family is not here. Goose Lifter, a cook and a musician. Yes, thank you. Thanks, Goose Lifter. Thanks for joining. Definitely a better cook than I am a musician, but I'm going to try. Raziel's Lament, those picture magnets on the fridge are upside down and it's distracting. Oh yeah, okay. They're very difficult to get off. There we go. All right. I'm glad we got through that recipe, guys. I knew it was a difficult recipe to pull off. It required a lot of fancy knife work. It also required a lot of technical camera work, which I didn't know we were going to have, but thank goodness Quanto checked in from his European vacation to help here at Henry's Kitchen. So thank you very much, and he did. So anyway, let's go ahead and do this song. It's a song by Three Dog Night. I used to hear it a lot when I was a kid. But I don't know, I've never tried to play it. Did that one in a completely different key because I seem to remember the song being much more dynamic. Thanks, Beelzebub. That's very nice of you. Thanks, Loinks. Or Doinks. That was interesting, but you know, we did it. We did it, and that was a suggestion, I believe, from Caffey. Wanted to hear that song. And then we have a user on Discord named Wicked Delights who wanted to hear a couple of songs, starting with a song that I liked a lot that came out about 20 years ago. Peace Duder just resubscribed, thanks. Was it Napoleon Dynamite that had this song in it? Thanks, Shambles 9V. That's really cool. You know, I believe that song was written, and correct me if I'm wrong, I believe it was written by the great Paul Williams, who also wrote The Rainbow Connection by Kermit the Frog. I'm not positive about that. Sergi Nazarov, will you send a postcard from Jamaica to roast beef? Thanks, Game Master Flash. Sergi Nazarov says, will you send a postcard from Jamaica to roast beef? I'm sorry, guys, but thanks for that comment. It kind of touched me in a weird way, where I got very sort of choked up and emotional thinking about the idea of me sending a postcard from Jamaica to my buddy Roast Beef. I don't know, I just, that's about the cutest thing I've ever heard in my life, and it's just, I need a minute. Thanks. I wish I could. Maybe I will. I don't know. But thanks, Game Master Flash, for gifting a tier 1 sub to Page Master. And let's take a look at this next song. I think this was in Napoleon Dynamite, but it's a song by the White Stripes, written by Jack White, I believe. It's got a lot of lyrics.
Fall is here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell, brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence, books and pens, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Walk with me, Susie Lee, through the park and by the tree, we will rest upon the ground, look at all the bugs we found, safely walk to school without a sound. Safely walk to school without a sound. Here we are, no one else. We walk to school all by ourselves. There's dirt in our uniforms, chasing all the ants and worms. We clean up and now it's time to learn. We clean up and now it's time to learn. Numbers, letters, learn to spell. Nouns and books and show and tell. At playtime we throw the ball. Back to class, through the hall, teacher marks our height against the wall. Teacher marks our height against the wall.
I think this is the bridge.
We don't notice any time pass. We don't notice anything. We sit side by side in every class. Teacher thinks that I sound funny, but she likes the way you sing. Tonight I'll dream while I'm in bed. Silly thoughts go through my head about the bugs and alphabet. And when I wake tomorrow, I'll bet that you and I will walk together again.
Mess that part up.
I can tell that we are gonna be friends. I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
Here we go. That was a nice song requested by Wicked Delights. And thanks. Everyone typed force and says that song suits your voice, Henry. Thanks very much. I think it does too. I'm no stranger to trying a song here and having it be way too high, or sometimes it's too low, or sometimes I can't find the key at all. And it's really annoying, but you're right. I think that one is sort of right in there. And I appreciate that. I'm gonna have another guava snack.
They're pretty big.
If you want the snack, I'll give you the website. Creamy cheese and guava bites on my Dominican Kitchen. .com. That's what that was. So, if nothing else, this recipe came out great. Dram Kilgallen, you played guitar on Doug Stanhope's album, is that right? And that's very true. Thanks. Quanto wants me to describe the taste. Guava is unlike anything that you've had. I'd say it's close to grape jelly. But there's a reason that they use grape jelly instead of guava jelly, and that's that grape jelly just tastes better, I guess. But guava is interesting. Maybe it's a little bit like Maybe like a pear with sugar, a sweeter pear. Raziel's Lament says, or you can get the recipe from your local hash dealer. Yeah. Brickstone. Do you have any funny stories from your time on the Bob and Tom show? Probably so many, but none that are coming to mind. I might have to prepare that a little bit, but there's probably going to have to... there's tons of them. But none that I can come up with right at the very moment. But, yeah, 20 years of hanging out with Bob and Tom, two very good friends, and a lot of funny stuff there with the whole crew. So, okay, we've got another song from Wicked Delights here that was a request, and this is a song that I actually did a while back. But it was sort of in the beginning, and I guess that maybe people... Anakin EU says, have you ever been to Scandinavia? No, I haven't, but I think I am part Scandinavian. I'm not sure, but I think I am. But, okay, so let's take a look at this song. Well, Wicked Delight said that they wanted to hear anything from... Billy Idol, and we did this song here a few months ago, but maybe a lot of you guys missed it, but I think it's an appropriate song. It's called Dancing With Myself. On the floors of Tokyo, down in London to go with the record selection and the mirror reflection that's dancing with myself when there's no one else in sight on the crowded lovely night. Well, I wait so long to bend a love vibration and I'm dancing with myself. Oh, oh, I'm dancing with myself. Oh, oh, I'm dancing with myself. Well, there's nothing to lose. Dancing with himself, not by himself, but with himself, which is interesting choice of words there. There we go. I'm going to have one more guava cracker here and maybe take a couple more questions, but I think pretty soon here. Kira Slavia says, do you know how to dance with yourself? I don't know any other way, to be honest with you. Sova Peruna 2, any Johnny Cash you could play? Wow. Well, We've done a couple of Johnny Cash. We did Hurt, which is really more of a Nine Inch Nails song, but Johnny Cash covered it really well. But here, I'm going to try, because I don't like to turn down people. Let's try... oh boy. I know I'm going to hate myself for trying this one, because what happens is I've never tried it before and I get the key all wrong. And then they end up on YouTube for all of the rest of history, however much time that is. But you know, you guys are my friends, so I don't think I really care about that stuff anymore. So let's just go ahead and see what we can do. Love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring, bound by wild desire. I'm in the way wrong key or something. Burns, 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 that ring of fire. I'm getting this from Ultimate Guitar Chords too, so if it sounds wrong, it's definitely their fault. How does that chorus go? I fell into a burning ring of fire. There we go. I went down. Well, I tried to do that one, and I'm sorry it sucked, but let me see if there's a way we can redeem ourselves with Hurt from Johnny Cash. Wait, somebody subscribed there, so let me go back to the... I can't read that, but it looks like maybe it's in an Asian language, I believe, but thanks for resubscribing for 4 months. Along with Peace Duder, okay. One Man Butterbean, I missed One Man Butterbean, and Zasamel, and Ligos 96, Upside Down Ace, yeah, okay, Knifey McEdge. I'm sorry if I'm missing anybody here, but, alright, let's see if we can get this one here, because it's a beautiful song. I think Johnny Cash kind of made it his own. This one, but I usually listen to them before. It's hard with the chords.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on
sing this to dates when I'd bring him back to my apartment.
The old familiar sting.
It never worked out.
To try to kill it all away, but I remember everything. What have I become? My sweetest friend. It all.
part of that was pretty good, I guess. It was okay. Anonymous gifted a tier one sub to Henry Phillips. Wow, that's cool. Thanks, Anonymous. And thanks, everybody. I think it's probably time that we start wrapping up because I have a trip that I'll be making on a banana boat. But I want to thank everybody for joining me on a remote stream. I do travel every now and then, and when I travel, I not only miss roast beef, but I also miss you guys, and I want to keep this going the best that I can. So that's what we were trying to do here, and I think we did it. But I want to go back and say thank you to some of the very important people here. Oh.
Okay.
Who was that? That was Shambles 9V. I want to thank the moderators. Dingo Bop, Faw Can, Dom Beef, Hottest Bear, Dude Dingle, Dog Goggy, Dr. Flanges, and Backhoose. I want to thank Quanto for abandoning his family on a European vacation so that he could come help us out with some very important information on the stream here. Thanks, Quanto. I also want to say, I want to thank Nim. Nim actually reached out to me to see if I'd play a game with him, and I couldn't do it because I've got this weird system here. I don't have my game controller. Oh, Quanto's honeymoon. Okay, so I didn't know if that was public information or not, but I want to thank Quanto for abandoning his new bride to come be with us and give technical support to Twitch community. So thanks, Quanto, and I hope that you're able to repair any bad things that happen from leaving your honeymoon temporarily to help us out here. Thanks. That's very awesome. And let's see. And I want to thank Nim. Nim asked if I'd play a game with him, but I just couldn't do it because I didn't have any real wherewithal to do it. But I'd like to do more of that because Nim is the guy who got me started here. Coming up on almost a year ago. It's been almost exactly a year since he had me on his Twitch stream to teach him how to make peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. And then I remember New Year's doing a message and vowing that I was going to start a Henry's Kitchen Twitch channel. And if you compare the way that I looked a year ago to the way I look now, it's been a rough year, but it's been very fulfilling because there's been a lot of new people in my life, and that's you guys. So thank you. I also want to thank all these big-time streamers. I want to thank Emeru because last time we streamed, Emeru gifted 100 subs, and that was amazing. Emeru, of course, is a new friend, and I taught her and Bonnie and S-Fand. Thanks, Street Meat for Cheap and S-Fand, and they invited me into their house, which not a lot of people do. To go in there and teach them how to make Frankenstein cupcakes. And they're just good friends, and I'm just very happy about that. And they also show the Henry's Kitchen videos, and that is wonderful. Along with Moon Moon. Moon Moon's been very supportive as well. Forsen, XQC, Brian W. Foster. And I also, as always, want to thank some of the early people that helped me out with the launch into the Twitch community, and that's Bumblevision, my pal Bumblevision, and the LGX, and Sir Doom, and Daisy Blossom. I also always like to thank Melon95 and Pilskman for offering up their help as well, and I just want to say thank you to you guys for joining me today. Zodbane says I should send Emeru an apron. She tried to get one, but they were sold out. Oh, okay. Well, this is the big news, everybody. I'm going to be stocking up on aprons for the holiday sales. I don't have them yet, but they're supposed to be coming, so I'm going to have aprons in the next week or so. And you're absolutely right. I should send Amaru an apron for sure. That just seems like a logical thing to do. Like, I should also give Quanto VIP status. I've never given anybody VIP status. This is all new to me. Apparently, it's a thing you can do now that I'm a partner. But if anybody deserves it, I would say it's Quanto for literally jeopardizing his new marriage on his honeymoon to come help us with technical matters. That definitely deserves that, as for sure. So I'm going to take another bite of our delicious meal. This came out great today, and there was some pretty heavy-duty cooking involved. You know, I had to buy the ingredients. I had to cut them up into different slices, and I had to arrange them in an assembly form to prepare them for being eaten. So all right. Let's do this. Hold on. I'm going to go to Twitch. I'm going to go to the chat. I'm going to go... let's see here. I have to find chat, and I'm going to take Faucan's advice here. What I'm doing is I'm typing in wait, can you say that again, Faucan? What do I have to type to... Oh yeah, / VIP Quanto. Okay, that's what I'm going to do. / VIP. Does it have to be capital? Okay. I think we did it. Did we do it? All right, we've got our first VIP person, and it's Quanto. Hauser says it looks a little complicated, and then I didn't see the rest. Yeah, it is pretty complicated. But yeah, a very momentous occasion here, and there's going to be a lot more to come. So, once again, thank you everybody for helping. Thanks, Quanto. And thanks, chat, for this remote stream and for making it work, because it was, I was pretty sure it was going to be a huge failure. And it might have been, but I feel good about it. And let's all enjoy the rest of our day. Okay, thanks again.